Hi everybody, this is Nick. Today I'm going to teach you how to make a really cool cover slide. This is not the really cool cover slide. This is a slide you've probably used before many, many times in your work. It's one of PowerPoint's stock templates, and it's really nice of Microsoft to provide us with these templates, but they're overly used. Sometimes they're kind of poorly designed when it comes to information design. They're not simple, they're not clean. Sometimes they just have a lot of design extras that you don't really need on the slide. So I want you to kind of remove yourself or relieve yourself of the burden of using these PowerPoint templates and start making your own. The best template for you and for your reporting or your presentation design is the template that you design yourself. So I'm going to click over here to the next slide, and I have this nicely custom designed slide. Look how nice it is. We have a really big title. It's left aligned. We have a nice little subheader that gives us sort of the year. You're probably going to want that. We have a great sort of white section at the bottom of the slide that is a great place to put logos or partnership logos, things like that. And then we have a really beautiful photo that aligns with the content of the report. Now this photo is kind of zhuzhed up. It's with my own little personal flourish here. It's actually two photos. We've made videos about how to remove backgrounds from photos in PowerPoint before, but we actually have one photo. It's the same photo, it's a duplicate photo, but we've removed the background on one of them and moved it to the front. So I'm gonna go ahead and walk you through all the steps to make this cover slide, and I hope that you can use these tips and tricks. It's kind of pulling a lot of different design techniques together to make a really classy and classic cover slide. So I'm going to go ahead and escape out of this slide, and let's go ahead and just make it. So the first thing I want to do is just make insert a photo. So let's go up here to the insert picture menu right there. I'm going to say stock images, and what I searched here is museum, because this is going to be for my museum visitor experience report at the end of the year. So I just typed in museum, and then we can see this photo right here. Now, if you want a little design trick, the first thing that we want to do when we get this photo here is I'm going to duplicate it. So push Control D. Now we have two photos. I'm going to put them right on top of each other. Now the thing that you could do is you could export this photo, you could save this photo, go over to a program like Canva, and you can remove the background really easily in Canva. They have a much better remove background generator. I don't know what the technology is, but PowerPoint is still a little bit buggy. I'm gonna do it in PowerPoint and you're gonna see how it works, but you have to click around to sort of remove that background. So we're gonna go ahead and just with this top photo selected, I'm gonna remove the background up here on the picture format tab, just click remove background. And then it's gonna remove what it thinks to be the background. So you can see all of the purple areas are what it's going to remove. And I don't want it to remove a lot of this sort of focal image of the woman and the girl here. So what I'm gonna do is go up here to mark areas to keep. Click on that and then just kind of click around a little bit through the areas that you wanna keep. And PowerPoint will start sort of guessing what you want to sort of keep in this thing. So I'm just gonna kind of click around here, and you have to click around quite a bit to sort of get the right feature and the right action here. So I'm just gonna do like this, and sometimes it's just like a little double click up here on the hand. That might work there. The finger I still need, so I'm gonna double click right there. And then let's see, we have like the girl's hair. And then once that happens, we'll see what pops up there. Looks pretty good. I think this shoe on the girl needs to be, but then you can see some of the floor is removed. So I wanna remove that. So I'm gonna remove, go up to the mark areas to remove, and then we're gonna go ahead and remove the floor. We'll see if that works. That actually kind of worked. I still wanna remove this man in the back. And then I wanna remove this. Now I think if you went over and did this in Canva, you'll find that it's gonna be just a little bit easier. But I wanted to try and do this right in PowerPoint. I think that's gonna work. I'm just gonna do a little click right there. All right, I think this is gonna be pretty good for us. So then once we're done, we're gonna say keep changes. Now I can move this. Now you can see that the background has been removed from the photo. Pretty cool trick. So now what we're gonna do is I'm going to actually just highlight all of these and we're going to align them to the right. And I know that I don't want this focal image or the image of my slide to be in the center. So I'm just gonna drag this over. Remember, anything that you put over the edge of a slide is not going to be shown in slideshow mode. So you can really work the edges. You can bleed pictures off of the edges. You can put things over here off to the side on the pasteboard, and nobody will see them when you're in presentation mode. So that's kind of also a nice little trick. Now let's go ahead and put in a text box for the title. Insert a text box. We're gonna do a nice big title here. I'm gonna say it's museum experience, survey, report. Now I want to make sure that the text box is set so that it doesn't auto shrink the text. So what we're going to do in the format text box options right over here, I'm going to click on this box right here, and right here it says resize shape to fit text. That's actually really good. So I want to keep that. Sometimes it defaults to shrink text on overflow. We don't want that. So I'm going to say resize shape to fit text. I'm going to just move this over here, and now let's go ahead and increase the font size nice and big. I'm going to make this bold. And actually, let's do Aptos Extra Bold. I like that. And we'll move this over here. I think that looks pretty nice. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to add another rectangle. So let's add a rectangle here. And I'm going to add this rectangle so that it's right here. This is my custom color of blue. I'm going to say no outline. And then let's make this a gradient fill because I want it to be really solid blue on the left and kind of fade into kind of 100% transparency on the right. So let's go over here in the format shape menu, click on gradient fill. And you can see I've already done these stops here, but if you wanted to do them from scratch, just click on the direction over here. And I would say one of these directions linear, make sure it's linear. And then one of these kind of stock directions with dark to light. And then on the solid fill, that's just going to be, you can see you can drag it over here and that's where the gradient comes in. But on the first color stop over here, for the color on the right, it's kind of opposite on my screen right here, I set this transparency to 100%. If I move this all the way to zero, then it's just a regular rectangle. But I'm going to go ahead and set the transparency to 100%. And I think that looks pretty good. Let's send this to the back. And let's turn our title white. So we're just going to turn that title white, and then I'm going to go ahead and let's just move the front photo there, and then I'm going to send the back photo all the way to the back. Perfect. And now you see we can drag this photo right on top, and it looks perfect. Really, really cool. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and insert that footer bar. It's just another rectangle right here. And this is a really great technique. Even if you don't do the remove background technique, this is still a great technique for a nice, custom, clean, and beautiful cover slide. No outline and white right there. That looks really good. And if we wanted to clean up the slide, we could put this right to the edge of the slide if we wanted to. Let's go ahead and just, I'm gonna move this and let's crop the photo here. So we're gonna crop the photo onto the slide border. That's perfect. And now we can move that photo back, right, perfect there. And now what we'll do is we'll move this to the front. And now you can see that focal image comes on top of that white footer bar. Now, let's see, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move this, I'm gonna move that rectangle there so that's a nice perfect slide. This would be a great place for a logo. You can see on the example slide, I have this is my logo. So whatever your logo is, I'm just gonna copy that with Control C and paste it in. You can put it right there. I like that for a logo position. I'm gonna just nudge this text box a little bit up, and then you can see on my first one, I wanted to have just this like 2023 results summary, kind of a little subtitle or a year placeholder, so we can go ahead and do that as well. So that's just gonna be another text box. I'm gonna put that in here, 2023 results summary, and then let's just work I'm gonna change this to Aptos Narrow. We'll make that bold. I'm going to turn that text white. And then let's make the fill of the text box another color. I'm going to do that orange so that it pops out. It's another color from my brand palette too. It's pretty nice. If you wanted the text spacing, the line spacing, you could adjust that here. So of the title, we could go ahead to the paragraph styles launcher right here. You can see it's set to single right now. But I think it's because that font is so big, it looks like there's a lot of space in between. So if we wanted to do multiple, just click on multiple here. And instead of one, which would be single spacing, let's try 0.8 and see what happens. And then click OK. And you can see then that squishes it just a little bit. So that's another way to sort of do that. And I'm going to go ahead and just drag that down here. We'll drag the subheader up And it looks like a really beautiful cover slide. Let's put this in slideshow mode. And this is, it only took just a few minutes to do this slide. Again, you don't have to do that whole remove background trick of the photo. I just really like that technique. It adds a lot of depth to the photo and kind of some movement and some texture. But you could get away with just a beautiful photo in the background as well. It's a nice, clean, classic cover slide that is not a stock PowerPoint template. So I hope you don't use those. I hope you make your own templates. Remember, the best template in PowerPoint is the one that you make yourself. I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in information design, data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, and Word. I had a great time making this for you. I hope you had a great time watching, and I can't wait to see you all next time.